Welcome to drillingcontractor.org. This is Kelly Ainsworth Robinson at the 2018 IADC Drilling Onshore Conference in Houston. I'm with Kenny Baker, Superintendent of Cactus Drilling, who gave a presentation this morning on the importance of stopping the job. Thank you for joining us, Kenny. How are you?
Doing fine. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. A lot of accidents on the rig come from unsafe acts. In your experience, why do people perform unsafe acts on the job and fail to stop the job?
You know, in my presentation, I mentioned complacency and also clueless, just don't know. Lots of times it's not that we do an unsafe act on purpose or that we're just going to do an unsafe act. Sometimes they do unsafe acts, you know, just they've done them before. And, you know, and I talk about in my presentation about being invincible. We just think, oh, it ain't going to happen to me. I've done this 100 times. So, you know, that's a lot of the unsafe acts is the complacency. We just didn't know that that was going to happen.
Can you tell us about the hazard hunts that you do on Cactus rigs to make sure that employees are aware of the risks that they face?
We're talking about stop the job a lot, and that's kind of one of the things that we do. And, you know, we come up with the stop the job, and everybody talks about it. And we come up with not the first stop of stopping the job. First step in stopping the job is recognizing a hazard. So that's how we come up with the hazard hunts, getting the guys just being aware of what's going on, looking and trying to see, kind of get your head on a swivel and be looking for unsafe things and doing these hazard hunts and get into kind of a everyday system, knowing that, you know, I'm looking around and just not being complacent. So the one thing is just the hazard hunts, just training them, getting them, you know, in the culture of always looking and being safe and watching what's going on at all times.
And can you tell us how you make safety personal by talking about the ripple effect of on-the-job accidents and fatalities?
The ripple effect was I was in a safety meeting for Devon in the Delaware Basin, which is the Permian Basin, and they asked me a question about the ripple effect. How many people would it affect if you died? And me and my dad had passed away 20 years ago here in October. So October the 5th, as a matter of fact, I kind of knew the ripple effect. I knew the ripple effect, like, personal on that. So that was kind of why I do the personal deal, just showing people what happens to families or what happens if somebody's here today, gone tomorrow type deal. What would happen if somebody died on a drilling rig? You know, you don't have the chance to say goodbye, and just talking about stuff like that. So it really gets to people when they see the effects of what happens when somebody does fatality. And then, you know, lots of times we don't talk about things that they're uncomfortable with, and that is something that it's uncomfortable to talk about when somebody passes away. So that's how come I make it personal.
Kenny, thanks so much for stopping by and talking about the importance of stopping the job and how to make sure that happens.
Well, I want to thank the IADC. This is a passion of mine to do the stopping the job, and, you know, the cactus story that I did with the tornado, we tied that all into stopping the job. And it just shows you that if you do stand up and you do stop the job and you do tell people, that you can save lives.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us on drillingcontractor.org.